In our last video, we saw how we can create a vortex ring using droplets of milk or droplets of food coloring. But what makes this so interesting? And what's the science behind how it works? Welcome back to Corey's Curious Science, where we show some interesting experiments that you can do in your kitchen or your classroom. Thank you to everyone who commented with observations with what happened in our first video on vortex rings. Now let's explore the science behind why this happens. Based on your comments and my own observations, there are about five main things that are going on here, or five things that are interesting about the vortices that we've been creating. The first is that the liquid in the vortex ring doesn't seem to be mixing with the water outside. And this is interesting because if you drop a droplet of water in the top, we create waves along the surface, but these waves only transfer the movement energy and they don't transfer the liquid themselves. And you can see this because the food coloring doesn't travel along the surface. But in our vortex ring, you can see that the color actually moves as the ring goes down the glass. So it's the same water that we put in at the top that continues right down through the glass. Number two, and probably the most obvious one, is that we form a ring, but we drop in a circular droplet. So what's going on here? Well, basically what's happening is our circular droplet falls into our water and the water around the circular droplet isn't moving. And this means as the droplet tries to fall through the water, the outside of the droplet moves more slowly because there's kind of a friction between the droplet and the water around it. When we have the outside moving slower and the inside moving faster, we get this kind of circular movement. And we call the circular movement a vortex. And that's why we've got our vortex rings. Observation number three is that when the ring gets down to the bottom, in say our Milky Vortex rings, it tends to spread out and get bigger. And this is because inside our vortex, the liquid is moving around in a circular kind of way. But if our vortex was to actually hit the bottom of the glass, we wouldn't be able to have the circular movement of the liquid. So to avoid this, our vortex tries to move outwards to try and avoid hitting into the bottom of the glass. And this is why it gets bigger when it hits the bottom. Observation number four was the fact that when we had our food dye, as our rings went through the glass, they were splitting into smaller rings. And the reason for this is that our water inside our glass isn't perfectly still. So if there are some small differences with how the water is moving, then our vortex ring starts to break up into separate little droplets. And in each of these droplets, the same thing happens to what happened to our original droplet. The outside goes slower and the inside goes faster. And so we end up creating separate rings all around where our original ring was. Finally, you might have noticed that our rings get slightly bigger as they go down into the glass. And this is especially obvious with our food coloring rings. And the reason for this is we've got a fancy word called diffusion. And diffusion is the fact that inside our liquid, our molecules aren't all moving in the same direction. They're actually moving in all sorts of directions. And the fact that they're moving in all sorts of directions means they want to try and spread out and mix with our water. Now, of course, if our rings are going down very slowly, you can see that as they're trying to spread out, they get wider. If the rings are moving faster, like the milk rings in the ones that I've tried, it means that it doesn't have as much time to spread out. And so it's less obvious that the ring is getting bigger, although it will be getting slightly bigger. Now these vortex rings are actually really useful and they pop up in a variety of places. Perhaps one of the most obvious places you might see them is if you ever go kayaking. As you pull your paddle through the water, it creates little vortex rings on either side of your paddle. The same thing happens on things like planes and cars as they travel through the air, but it's just harder to see. Now if I missed anything and you have any questions, please let me know in the comments. And stay tuned for our next episode of Corey's Curious Science. Happy sciencing!